Hello everyone, welcome to Gore Mountain here at Lake Placid 2023, the FISU World University Games. It is the snowboard cross competition kicking off the freestyle and snowboard here at Gore Mountain, and we're at the final stages of the contest, the semi-finals, small finals and big finals coming up over the next hour or so. And I'm pleased to say the weather has got just a little bit better at the venue. Well, earlier on today, it was raining, it was foggy. Still a little bit of fog around here at Gore Mountain, but it has lifted. Temperatures have just gone down a fraction, but most importantly, the rain has stopped falling. That is key. And the atmosphere is good. Adirondack Mac is out. He's going to be watching from the finish lines. A lot of support for all of the riders. We're at the final stages after the round robin competition earlier on today to get our top eight women and men for these semi-finals. And those round robins have given us our seedings for this final stage. So two semi-finals, top two in each semi-final progress into the big final. They will race for the medals. No mistakes. This is a very tactical race. Chatting with some of the coaches, unsure of what wax to use. Still around about 1 degrees. It does feel a little bit colder. We'll get a look at the course profile. 965 meters in length. Yesterday it was running 54, 55 seconds for the men, 58, 59 for the women. A little bit slower today. Ninka Elizabeth Hendrika-Pohl will go in semi-final number one. She'll wear the red bib. Subin Wu will wear green. She went through in second. She's the second ranked rider in this semi-final. Anna Valentin from France in blue. And Kim Martinez, also from France, in yellow. She was the last rider to make it through into these semi-finals. So top two to progress. Netherlands, Korea, two riders from France, all about to battle it out. Here at the World University Games, Lake Placid 2023, we're up at Gore Mountain. New York State's largest ski area, our snowboard area, because we're snowboarding today. So here we go, first semi-final, lined up in the start gate. We are ready to go. This is the one you want to be in, but now you've got to negotiate and get through it. Strong start from Supine Wu from Korea. She is out in the lead, followed by Kim Martinez, and Ninka Pohl on the high line makes the pass up in a second. Pohl nearly down. We'd lost Martinez. She gets moving again. Pohl being put under pressure by Valentin, and Valentin up into second place, and Ninka Pohl, the top qualifier, the leader after the round robin stage, is in danger here. Takes the high line again. She's got speed, but has to put the brakes on. Ninka Pohl makes a little bit of contact with Valentin. Oh, Paul's down. Three riders down. Drama in the first of the semi-finals. And Kim Martinez comes from nowhere into top spot. Ninka Pohl is up on her feet again. And it looks like she's in second, but Martinez from nowhere takes advantage of a huge moment in this competition. Ninka Pohl gets lucky that she was able to get back on her feet. And Kim Martinez, the eighth-ranked rider, coming into the semi-finals, is in the big final along with Pohl. But we could be unpicking this one for hours and hours. Pohl in red is up high. She moves in front of Martinez, clips her board, but she keeps moving. That's what pushes Martinez to the back of the pack. Pohl still looking for a way into a top two position at this point. Just clatters into Valentin, loses her balance. At the same point, Wu goes down, Valentin goes down. And then Kim Martinez comes through the middle, says, thank you very much, I'm going to the final. Well, Pohl is lucky, but that's what can happen in this game. Wu and Valentin into the small final. Semi-final two in the start gate. Bridget McLean of Canada in blue, Chloe Passerat from France in green. Sophie Hettinger of Switzerland in red. Karen Fujita from Japan in yellow. Well, let's hope for a close race. Will it be as dramatic?
Racers ready.
Who is going to race? Paul and Martinez for the medals. Here we go, second semi-final. Good start from Hettinger. Passera with a quick start as well, but it's Hettinger in prime position going into the first of the turns. Passerat in second place, McLean in third, Fujita in fourth. Long way to go in this one though. Anything can and usually does happen in snowboard cross racing, but it's still Hettinger who had a really strong round robin phase in the lead. Passerat in second place. Hettinger just a little sideways coming into the bank, and that allows Passerat to close that gap. Oh, and the rider in blue, McLean, was closing, but she goes down. Fujita's in trouble as well. So these two riders should be able to see this one out and get into the big final. Sophie Hettinger still in the lead with Passerat for company. Doesn't matter which order they finish in here. The seedings will stay the same for the final. But Hettinger takes it. Passerat in second. Fujita comes through in third. She moves into the small final. McLean went down pretty hard. Canadian, she's in the small final as well. We haven't seen her just yet. Is she in the finish area? Well, into the first turn. It was a great start from Sophie Hettinger. Led right from the off. Didn't let up. Pushed hard by Passerat. But at this stage, McLean is closing in. But a slightly heavy landing catches the heel edge, and just that gap grows a fraction more. But McLean in blue does run a tight line there and just gets caught out. For me, you've got to be a bit further off the line. And the Swiss and the French riders progressing. So we've got our final lineups, the women's final. It will be Ninka Paul, Kim Martinez, Sophie Hettinger, and Chloe Passerat. All smiles from Hettinger and Passerat. They will race for a medal. It's now time to get back to the top as quick as possible. We've got the two men's semi-finals to come. So semi-final one for the men. As that gate just about looks like it's been fixed. It is an outside panel, so that's all fine. Bruno Tatarco in yellow, Benjamin Gattaz in red, Leon Beckhaus in green, Nicola Lubash from Switzerland in blue. Well, this is tough. Gattaz won all five of his heats in the round robin. Beckhaus won four of his. Lubash has looked quick. Lots of two wins, third place, a second place. It's Gattaz and Beckhaus. Beckhaus gets the best of the stars, but Gattaz is going to come through. Is he? Beckhaus right on the tails of the Frenchman. Lubash running in third place. Tatarco in fourth, but Beckhaus trying to catch up with Gattaz, who leads the race. Starting to string out just a little. See the riders dropping in sideways. Oh, Lubash is down. Lubash down and out. Avoids the B netting. It'll be the small final for him. And now Bruno Tatarco from the Czech Republic is trying to chase down Leon Beckhaus from Germany. But Benjamin Gattaz has looked like the man to beat today. He has been flawless in the semi-final. He goes through to race for a gold medal along with Beckhaus of Germany. France and Germany into the big final. Out of the start gate, Beckhaus and Gattaz exceptional out of the gate. This stage, Beckhaus gets the nose of the board just in front. quite to be, and they nearly collided in that first turn. And this is where Lubesch goes down. He's in touch with the leaders, but he's on the heel edge and loses that board to snow contact. So first of the men's semi-finals is complete. There's the official result.
Well, some good racing action and getting stacked and back up here. You like what we're seeing? Semi-final number one done for the dudes. Now we take our attention off to the semi-final number two for the guys, and it's France versus Czech Republic.
Three Frenchmen in this second semi-final. The seedings had worked out a little differently. They could have potentially had an all-French final. But they could still lock the podium out because we've got Guillaume Herpin in red, Quinton Sodogas in green, Titouan Kotre in blue, and Jakub Zarava from the Czech Republic in yellow. Herpin with a very strong start. He picked up 18 points in the round-robin format. Sodogas, he's in second, Kotre in third, but Kotre's been pushed hard by Zarava. Zarava tries to move on the inside, and Kotre's down. Titouan Kotre down and out of the race. It is Herpin and Sodogas in the front. He's got to nearly take each other out. Oh, Herpin, one of the favourites, is down. Sodogas made contact with him. Oh, the French team are going to be fuming about that one. And it means Jakub Zarava from the Czech Republic is sitting in second place. And he's going to go through to the big final along with Quinton Sodogas. Huge moment in the men's semi-finals. That is what this course has done all day long. It has thrown up surprises. Kotre into the small final as well. No medal for him today. Here Kotre has problems entering the turn. Zarava didn't make contact with them. Here's Sodogas in touch. And they just come together. Herpin chatting away to Sodogas. I think that conversation might continue on a little bit later. Sodogas and Zarava into the big final. Again, said it before, that's snowboard cross racing. These things can happen. Women's final lined up, ready to go. Here at Lake Placid 2023. Gold, silver, and bronze up for grabs. We're going to find out who takes home the hardware over the next minute or so. Riders get the command to enter the start gate. Then it will be riders ready. Attention. Then any time within 5 seconds after that, the board will drop. And it does, women's big final underway. The green bib of Hedinger gets a good start, but all four of these riders so evenly matched. Hedinger coming out of the first turn in the lead. It's rough, it's bumpy, but it's the same for everyone. Oh, we got a bit of contact. We've lost the red bib. Ninka Paul down in fourth place. Hedinger leads the way. Passerat in second, Martinez in third. Ninka Paul has got to throw everything at this now. A medal still on the cards for Ninka Paul as Martinez goes down. I think she took Paul out as well. Paul had nowhere to go, but it's Sophie Hedinger of Switzerland leading the World University Games final. Second place is Chloe Passerat right now. Ninka Paul is not going to get a medal here unless something dramatic happens. That is what this sport can do over the final jump. It is Sophie Hedinger of Switzerland who takes the gold medal. Passerat takes the silver. And Kim Martinez, the bronze medal here in the women's snowboard cross final at Gore Mountain. The Swiss fans celebrate. It is heartbreak for Paul after a superb qualifying yesterday. Unbeatable in the round robin. In the big final, she finishes in fourth, and that is going to be so tough to take. But here, Paul makes contact with Hedinger, causes her to lose all of her speed. She goes from a medal position to fourth in the blink of an eye. Hedinger pulling away. And here, Ninka Paul watching Kim Martinez as Martinez goes down. At this point, I thought Paul was going to ride through, but didn't see what happened to Paul. Maybe she went down in the same incident. Fantastic performance from Kim Martinez. You do feel for Paul. But it's Switzerland on the top step of the podium. Swiss fans celebrated wildly as heading across the line. So it's Beckhuis in blue, Sonogas in green, Gattaz in red, Zarava in yellow. The men's big final here at Lake Placid 2023 FISU World University Games. Riders get the command from the starter. Here we go, big final. Waiting for the board to drop. It does now, big final underway. It's a superb start from the German out on the left-hand side. Oh, now he's ended up just losing a little bit of pace. And the German now down in fourth, but leading right now, Benjamin Gattaz. Quinnen Sonogas runs very high. That might open the door for Beckhuis. Sonogas going to have the inside line, and Zarava up in second place. Beckhuis and Sonogas battling for third and fourth. Zarava has been the surprise package today, put together a superb series of races, but it is Benjamin Gattaz who leads the way in this men's big final. Beckhuis in fourth place, could be out of it unless there's some problems. Sonogas up into second place, looking to make it a 1-2 for France. Sonogas throws it all away, and Beckhuis might be able to grab a medal now. Over the final jump, Benjamin Gattaz from France comes through and takes the win. Second goes to Zarava. Beckhuis grabs a bronze medal in the end, but it's a lucky bronze. You've got a feel for Sonogas there. He was in a medal position, but it ain't over till it's over. A win for France in the men's race. Superb from Benjamin Gattaz. He won all five of his heats. Quick start from the two Frenchmen. Beckhuis in a bit of trouble on that bank turn, and the Czech rider was on the right line. It gave Beckhuis nowhere to go. Sonogas getting the timing wrong on that double. He's been going for a lot of doubles today. See Sonogas in green out on the right hand side. Here he's got the pace, he's up in second. It's looking like a French 1-2 at this stage. Beckhuis is thinking no medal today, but then Sonogas gets pushed down low, straddles a gate there. It's probably a DNF actually for Sonogas. There you see, hands on head, and Gattaz taking the gold, Zarava the silver, Beckhuis the bronze. There are the final results. Gattaz, he only qualified in fifth place, ahead of Zarava in sixth. Takes home the gold medal. 17th and 18th, it's the slope style competition. 19th and 20th, big air. And then we finish here at Gore Mountain towards the end of the games with the parallel giant slalom and parallel slalom. Well, the medalists making their way to the podium. Sophie Henninger in the middle, that number one spot. Passerat in second. Martinez in third.
The mascots will be presented by Peter Oleski, FISU Executive Committee member. Third place, representing France, Kim Martinez.
Congratulations to Kim Martinez, picking up the bronze medal. She's not on the top French team. You don't see her on the World Cup Tour, but she's shown she's got the class and the skills that she could go on and have a great career.
Representing France, Chloe Passerot.
Chloe Passerot in second place. Two medals for France. Great race from Chloe Passerot. At her on deck, Mac, the gift been handed out.
And first place for your women's snowboard cross from Switzerland.
Something I'm sure in the future.
Sophie Hettinger.
Sophie Hettinger from Switzerland, the gold medalist. In the round robin format, she was second in the first
the
race and then just went win, 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 win.
World University Games winners.
Congratulations to the three women on the podium. Gold for Switzerland, silver and bronze for France. A few more photographs. And the men make their way towards the podium, the mascot ceremony.
Please welcome the winners.
A few more Adirondack Macs handed out to these three men. You can hear the wind blowing around. It's picked up throughout the day.
Third place, representing Germany, Leon Beckhaus.
The man from Munich grabs the bronze medal. It's always a battle for these riders to get anything out
second
of a snowboard cross race due to the nature of the
Czech
sport.
Republic, Jakub Zaraba.
Jakub Zaraba, silver medal, qualified in sixth place. Wasn't marked down as a clear favorite for a medal, but I'm so impressed with his riding today.
And first place.
Just snuck into
the
semi-finals as well.
Let's hear it for Ben Guitar.
Benjamin Guitar is the gold medalist here. Lake Placid 2023. Put together a flawless series of races in the round robin. Did the job in the semi-final and again in the final. The clear winner today brings his compatriots in for a photo.